Hello everyone, my name is Ashish and welcome to this Tag Instance channel. So like in my last lecture, we have discussed about how to write a custom finder method to fetch the data from the database using a Spring Data JPA, right? So here you can see that in my interface with the name like user repository, I have created the methods, the custom finder method to fetch the data according to the requirement. So requirement was that to find the data according to the city name. So there I have used the find by, and then I'm using the attribute in my model. So you can see that in my model class, I have the attributes like name, password, city, and we can find according to the name, according to the password, according to the city, just by writing the method, this method in my, like the user repository, right? So this is the custom finder method. And then we are fetching the data from the database. So in the same way, I have shown how to use the OR keyword to fetch the data. Let's say that I'm using find by, and then I'm using the name or city. It means that it is going to match with the name of the user and the city of the user, and then it is going to fetch the data from the database, right? So these are the scenario where I have shown you in my last lecture how to use the custom finder method. But today in this lecture, we are going to see the what are the another ways to fetch the data from the database. And let's say that you get one like scenario where you have to fire a complex query to fetch the data, right? To fetch the complex data. Then for that, you cannot like build the, you cannot build the custom finder method, right? For that, you have to fire a complex query. So today in this session, we are going to see how we can fire a complex query to fetch the data from the database using a Spring Data JPA. So for that also, we will create a method, and then we will annotate with the @ query. And then inside that @ query, we are going to write the query, and then we will fetch the data, right? So let's see how we can do it. So inside this only, inside the repository only, I'm going to write that method, and then we are going to fetch it, right? So we are going to use a JPQL and a native query. So JPQL is like a Java persistence query language. It is like same like a Hibernate query language, right? So let's see how we can integrate a JPQL and a native query to fetch the data from the database, right? So let's say that we have the user model, right? So user model has like ID, name, password, and the city. And I want to fetch all the users data from the database using a JPQL. And right, so here we have another way is to use a custom finder method, right? And we have another way to fetch the data using a JPQL or a native query. So here, first of all, we are going to see how to use a JPQL to fetch the data, right? So for that, what we will do, for that we will create a method public, and it will be, and here the list type will be the return type, right? So this is the user. All right, so let's provide the name get all user. All right, get all users using, let's say using JPQL. All right, so this is the method I have created here. All right, and here we can only declare the method because it is the interface, right? So we have to provide so for the JPQL in which we have to fire a query. So for that we have to use a query annotation. So let's import this, and in the body of the query or the parameter, we have to pass the query. So let's say that we are using JPQL. So for that we will use select U, and here let's say that U is my the alias name from the user table, right? So we have the user table, yeah, U. So this is the query we are firing to fetch the user from the database. So here it is select star from user, right? So yeah. So now, so here we have written a JPQL query to fetch all the users from the database. So now let's do one thing. So let me call this from my service. So here I will create one method in my service layer also, public, and the return type will be list. This is the user. So let's give the name get all users using jpql. So this is my service class method name, and inside this I need to call, let me return it, and user repository. All right, dot so we have created one method like get all users using jpql, right? So here we are calling this method, right? So here we are calling this method, and this method is calling or firing this query, and then this query will go to the database and it will fetch the data from the users table. All right, so here we have written our like service class implementation. Now let's go to controller, and here I will create one endpoint so that I can call with my like a third party, like a testing tool, that is the Postman. So let's create one endpoint for this. So return type will be same as the list, and the generic as the user. So let's provide the endpoint name, get all users using jpql. All right, and yeah, so this is the method. So we have to return, and here we can use user service to call the method get so get all user using jpql, right? So this is calling my like the service class method, and here we are going to call this method with the http get method. So let me use get mapping, and let's provide the URL. So get all users using jpql is my like the query, is my like the URL name. All right, so here you can see that. So let me save all the classes. Yeah, so here you can see that in the repository interface you have to only define you have to declare one method, right? And here the method return type is list, and you have to use @query, and then you have to provide your query. So here we are fetching all users available in my database. So I'm using star, and the u is the alias name from the user table, and the u is the alias name, right? So let me save it, and now let's go to the Postman. So before that, I'm going to copy my URL for this endpoint, get all user using jpql. All right, let's go to the Postman. So let's change the URL. So this is the get. So let's hit the send button. So after hitting the send button, you can see that we are able to fetch the data using the jpql. So here you can see that we got the two object, right, with the id 101 and the id 202. So here like we are able to fetch the user's data from the database, right, by using the jpquery. So in this way we can fire our like a custom query if we want, right? So let's see the another example, and let's see how we can use the more like the query type of like the functionality. So let's say that we have to pass some like the parameter, and we have to means pass parameter, and then we have to fetch the data. So here like we are fetching all data, right? Now let's say that according to some conditions, let's say that I want to fetch the data according to the city name, or according to the password, or according to the name of the user. Then let's say that how we can write this method by using jpql, in which we will pass some parameter and all, right? So for that we have to create one method with the list type user. So let's provide name get user by city. All right, so let's me fetch using jpql. All right, so this is my like so now we have to use the query annotation, right? So this is my query annotation, and in the body or in the parameter of the query we have to write our query which we want to fire. So yeah, so give here the now let's write select u is my alias name from the user table, All right, and this is the alias name, and now we have to provide the condition. So let's say that I'm providing the condition with the city name, right? So we are finding with the city. So you have to do where close, and then you have to do u dot city, right? U dot city and equals to, and then you have to use the colon, and then you have to write c, right? So this is my like the parameter. So here we are using the where close, and here we are passing the city. So you have to write select u from the user table. And this is the alias u, and this is the where close, and with the u and with the like where close, you have to write u dot city, and you have to provide the parameter. So for that equals to, you have to provide the colon and c, right? So this c is going, so here we are going to bind this c here, right? So for that we can so let me pass the string city, all right? So this is the string city, and then we have to bind this. So for that we can use a param annotation, right? So we can use the param annotation, yeah. And inside the param here we will use this keyword string like the c here, right? So I've written in the wrong place, yeah. So inside this you have to write the c. So here it is going to bind this. Let's say that we are passing this city. So this city is going to bind with this, and here our like and here our the query will get fire with the select u from the user where like the city equals to this city, right? So this is going to bind with this c, and then our like the query will get executed, right? So here we are using the param. So let me import this. All right, fine. Yeah, so this is the way in which we can pass like any parameter like city name. All right, so you have to only like keep in mind that you have to use equals to, and then you have to use colon, and then you can all right, and then you can here like provide any name like c, x, y, right? But you have to like match here like with the param. So it is going to bind the city with this C, and here our like the query will get executed, right? So now let me complete my service layer, and then we will see how we are getting the result or not. So in the same way, what I will do, simply I will copy this method, and here I will paste it, and then I will change it, right? So return type will be list only. So get user by city using jpql is my like the service class method name, all right? And here let me see what are the method is providing. Yeah, so we have to call this method get user by city using jpql, and here we need to pass the city. So it means that we have to take this city here. So let me write string city. All right, so we have completed our service class, and this method is also present in our like the repository. All right, now we have to create one endpoint. All right, so let me copy this endpoint and let me paste it. Yeah, and now I'm going to change the endpoint. So first of all, I'm going to change the URL. So let me write the URL get user by city using jpql is my like URL, and here we need to pass the city name. So for that I am using, and I'm passing the city here in the URL, right? And so let's change the method name also, get user by city using jpql. All right, and here we need to take this city. So for that I'm going to use the path variable. All right, so this is the path variable I'm using. So a string city, and I need to call the service class method that get user by city, this one, get user by city using jpql, and here we need to pass our city, right? So this is going to call this like the service layer method, and then it is going to execute, right? So here we are binding this city to this string, this city, and then we are passing this city to our service layer, and this and then it is calling our and then it is calling our this like interface method, and then it is going to bind this C value to our like the where clause, and then it is going to execute this query or fire this query, and then it is going to fetch this data according to the where clause, and then it is going to return us, right? So let me save all this file. So now we are going to execute this like the endpoint, and then we are going to check that whether we are getting according to my city or not. So let me copy this URL. So let's go to the Postman. Yeah, and here I need to copy this URL, right? Get user by city using JPQL, and then here I am passing the city name. So we have the two data with the Silli city name and with the Ranchi city name. All right. So let me fetch the user with the city Silli. All right. So here I mention Silli. So this is the get method. So let me hit the send button. So you can see that we are able to fetch the data from the database using the JPQL, in which we are passing the parameter of the city. So this parameter is going to it is calling the endpoint in my controller, and then it is like binding this data, I mean the city name, and here, and then it is calling the service layer. All right. And then it is calling this method, and here our like the query is like firing. All right. So in this way, we can fetch the data by passing the like the parameter also. And all right, and let's say that I need to pass some like n number of like the parameter, like more than one. So how we can use it, right? So for that also it is like simple. So let me show it. So let me copy this and then let me paste it, right? So here you can see that we are using select u from the user u where city is this, and let's say that I want to pass the name also, right? So how we can use the name also, right? So let me show you how. And all right, so here I'm going to use this find by name or city. So here we are going to use the or keyword, right? Or keyword. So either this name should match or this like city should match, which we are like finding in the database. If that matches, then it is going to fetch the data. So how we are going to write this by using a JPL query, right? So we are going to see this. So for that, yeah. So till here it is taking the city. Now I will use the or keyword, and in the same way I will do u dot name equals to, and you have to use the colon, and then you have to provide any like the variable. Let's say I'm providing n, and now you need to bind this n. So for that, here I will use the method, means here I will pass the parameter same like param. All right, and inside this I will use the same variable name n, and let's say name. All right, so this city will be bind with this where clause city, and this name will be bind with there here, right? And let me change get user by city or name using JPQL. So this is the method name, and here I'm using the query select u from the user where city is this or with the name is this, right? So let me call this method from my service layer. All right, so let me copy this again. So let's change city or name. All right. And here I need to pass the two like the arguments, city and the name. All right, so same here I need to pass. So let me call this directly. Yeah, so we are getting like get user by city or name using JPQL. All right, so in this we are passing city and name. So let me provide the semicolon. So in this way we have written our like the service layer. Now let's go to the controller and let's create one more endpoint to test that whether this method is working or not. So let me copy this again. And now what we need to do, so here we need to change the like the URL for this, right? Or I will add or name using JPQL, and here we need to pass the two like the parameter, right? the city and the name also. So for that, backslash and then the flower bracket, and inside this I will pass name, and then so change the method name also, get user by city or name using jpql. So in this way I need to use one more @ path variable, because I need to bind one more data from the URL whose value is name, right? So this, yeah, so this like city will be bind with this city variable, and this name will be taken or bind with this name variable. And here we already created a service class method, so let me copy this method. So get this one, get user by city or name using jpql. All right, so here we are passing the city and the name. Yeah, so guys, here we have completed our controller class also, service class also, and our repository also. So let me save all this class, go to the controller. Yes, so let's go to the controller and let me copy the URL for this endpoint. Copy it, and you have to pass the two parameter from the URL. So go to the postman. All right, go it here, paste it. Sorry, again I have to copy this URL. So this is my URL for this endpoint. Go to the postman, paste it here, and now I need to pass the two things. Either city or the name should match, then only it is going to fetch the data. So for the city name, I will pass, let's say, Ranchi. All right. And for the name, I will pass Asis. And then we have the get method, right? So let me send the request. So here you can see that we fetch the user, and it is going to fetch with the checking with the name city Ranchi, and the name should be Asis. Then only it is going to fetch. Right, so now I will change the name. So let so in the city name I am passing like Rani, and in the name I am passing S only, ASH, right? So this city name and the Asis is S is like not there in my database, so it should give us the result as an empty array, because the name with the city like the Rani and the name with the S is like not there in my database, right? So it is going to fetch an empty array. So let's hit it. So yeah, so here you can see that we are getting an empty array. It means that our like the query is working fine with the jpql. So till here guys, we have discussed how to write a jpql query to write our complex query, right? Here you can see that we have written a complex query, and in the similar way you can write n number of like a complex query to fetch the data from the database. So we don't need to like write all the implementation of the method. You have to just like declare one method, and then you have to write the query with the annotation query, and then you can like fire the query, and then you can fetch the data. So these are all are the jpql query. So now we are going to see how to write a native query. So let's say that you are using a MySQL or SQL database, right? So for that we are going to see how we can use a native query also to fetch the data, right? So here inside my user repository, I will create one more method. Let's say, so return type will be list. All right, so generic will be user. Now let's say that I will fetch like whole user. So get all users using native query is my like the method declaration name. All right, so here guys, you have to remember in the same way you have to use the query annotation for this also, that's fine, but the difference is here. So let's say that you have to use a native query. So I am using here. So here I am using a MySQL. So I will use a MySQL query. So let's say that select, right, star from the table name. So table name is So table name is like user. All right. So this is my like a general like a native query, and then you have to use native. query, you have to do true. All right. So by this way, it means that so here, like Spring Boot is going to read that we are using a native query. So it is going to change this query to according to your database you are using. So let's say that you're using the Oracle, then it is going to use the Oracle query. Otherwise, let's say that you are using a MySQL, then it is going to use a MySQL one, right? And you have to assign this query to a value. So you have to pass this with the value. Now it's fine. So you have to use like value equals to your query. So here I'm using select star from like user, right? So here like the user is my like a table name. And here you have to write like a native query equals to true. It means that it is like activating that it is activating the native query one, right? And in the similar way, you can write our like the service class, the implementation method as you have written. So let me write it quickly and then I will show you the result that whether it is working or not. Paste it here. Now I need to change some values. All right. Get all users using native. All right. And here I don't need to require to pass the parameters for this. Yeah, so already I have created the method in my repository. So I will call this method. This one, get all user using a native query. All right. And let me do a semicolon. All right. So this is my service layer. Now I need to create one endpoint so that I can call this endpoint from my Postman. All right. Let me copy this. Paste it here. Now I'm going to change the name. So first of all, I'm going to change the URL. All right. So get users using native. All right. So I don't need to require to pass this parameter here. All right. Let me change the method name also. Get user using native. All right, I don't need to require these arguments for this. Remove it. So already I have the method in the service layer. So let's see the method name, get user. This one, get all user using native. All right. So now guys, you can see that I have written my like the endpoint, and the endpoint URL is this. And it is going to hit my like the service class method, and then it is going to hit my like repository method, and this is the repository method I have declared, and here I am using a native query. So for that I have written a native query equals to true, and then I have written my like the native query here like select star from user. So it is going to fire the query, and then it is going to fetch all the users information from the database. All right, so let me save it. So let's go to the controller and let's copy this endpoint URL, go to the Postman, change this URL. Yeah. And now let's hit the send button. So we got some error, nested exception. Okay. So what is the error? Table user does not find. Okay. So it is not able to find the user. So let me see the query what I have written. Value equals to select star from user. So let me check if it was a small user or capital user. Hit it again. Yeah. So here guys, I have done a small mistake with the like the table name. So now you can see that I am able to fetch the whole data, right? So here, like I was able to fetch the whole data using a native query, right? So here, guys, only you have to keep in mind that you have to do a native query true, and then you have to write your own native query here with the query annotation. So guys, in this way, you have seen how to fetch the data from the two ways. So in my last lecture, I have shown you how to write your custom finder method to fetch the data, and then let's say that you have some like a complex query to execute, right? So for that, you cannot write a custom finder method. Then only you can use a query also to execute and to fetch the data according to your like requirement or anything. All right. All right, guys, thank you and have a nice day and see you in the next lecture.